नमस्ते, सुप्रभातम। I'm Dr. Mayur. I'm a neurosurgeon and I do surgeries on brain and spine. In addition to that, for many years I have been treating patients with neck pain, back pain, diabetes, hypertension, anxiety, depression, suicidal tendencies, so on and so forth. Even my surgical cases, I'm treating with the help of yoga, and there have been many cases where they have improved drastically and are enjoying physical, mental, social, and spiritual health. Here in Brahma Muhurta Yoga, which started 2 to 2.5 months back. Before that, we were streaming 6 to 7 in the morning. And as we thought, as the thought progressed, we see many things in this corona pandemic and thought of improving and repairing it with the help of the love for Mother Nature and love for the Sanskriti in which we are born. With that understanding, we started this Brahma Muhurta Yoga Challenge. And we are continuing on that, and more people are getting benefited from it. Now, today, as the request from Madhusudan ji came, that sir, please show me knee pain-related practices. Already these have been done, but it is always good to reintroduce the things. Already, I have, I think, more than 270 videos now. So all these are available on YouTube. I think headings also have been given about knee pain. You can search knee pain, Dr. Mayur Vikas Vaidyanathan. But if not, let us practice today once again. Why not? So with that understanding, we are going to practice for knee pain. It may have some few more innovative practices which were not discussed last time. And in addition to that, we do Bhagavad Gita chanting, one shloka per day, followed by asana, pranayama and mudras, and a bit of social awareness we are going to improve. With that understanding, let us begin today's session. Eyes closed, back erect, neck erect. Sit in a comfortable pose. Anything which is comfortable to you, sit in that. Gentle smile on your face. And focus only on your breathing. When you inhale, the abdomen is bulging. When you exhale, the abdomen is sinking down. Bulge your abdomen. Try to bring 1:2 breathing practice. That is, if you are inhaling for 5 seconds, exhale for 10 seconds, and with each breath, our body is becoming more and more relaxed. Shoulders are relaxed, elbows are relaxed, palms are relaxed, index fingers are gently touching the tip of the thumbs and trying to feel the pulse. The point at which we feel the pulse is the point at which the healing process intensifies in our body. Now slowly move the concentration to the nostrils. Let us feel the temperature of the air which is going inside. Cool air is going inside and warm air is gushing out. of contrast in practices where you can tell positive health in and negativity and disease out. Like that we can practice. And at the same time, we can keep the knowledge of temperature of the air on and feel it. Slowly move the concentration to the center of the eyebrows. Center of the eyebrows. Imagine one Omkar over there. While focusing on this Omkar, we are going to chant it 3 times. Inhale. Feel the effect of Omkar on your mind and body. Yesterday, we discussed about Nitya Yukta, means a person who is a Jnani, knowledge is there, theoretical knowledge, which is implemented into the practice, becomes Nitya Yukta, forever in the state of yoga. Today, we are going to understand Yukta Atma. Yukta is there and Atma. Atma means self. There are many, you know, social media derived meaning of Atma or Bollywood, Tollywood derived meaning of Atma. Atma means self. Atma means not that thing which they show on the television. Okay? Soul. Not something like a bhuta, okay? Atma here means self, yukta atma. Self is of two types, lower self and higher self. Within us, we understand that there is a person who wants to behave like an animal or behave in a very, you know, degrading manner. And at the same time, there is a person who wants to behave like a god or behave in the manner of good qualities, daiviya sampat, asuriya sampat, daiviya sampat. This also has been discussed in detail. So, what happens is, when we want to fuse our consciousness, we have to fuse this consciousness with the higher self rather than the lower self. Both the things are within us only, okay? So that higher self, when we fuse, it is considered to be Yuktatma, okay? Which is mentioned in 18th shloka of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Udara sarva aivete gnani tvatmaiva mematam asthita sahi yuktatma mamevanuttamangatim. Here, Bhagavan Sri Krishna wants to say that Udara Sarva Aivete. Sarva means, here he is talking about the shloka which we discussed, I think, 2 days back, where Chaturvidha means 4 types of people, Bhajante Maam, means they are worshipping the Supreme Consciousness. Here, Krishna means Supreme Consciousness. Krishna means, does not mean one idol. It is beyond idol. Krishna is everywhere. Krishna is not only an idol or not only one person. There is a Krishna within me also, there is a Krishna within you also. That Krishna is having complete amount of knowledge. For us, the file is zipped. It has to be unzipped. And there are many ways people do it. or many reasons for that people do it. One was artha. Artha means having difficult times and they are desperate. That is why they go and do bhajana of Supreme Consciousness. Then jigyasu. That means they are curious. Artharthi means they want to earn money. And finally, jnani. Those who have theoretical knowledge want to execute and experience. So here Bhagavan Sri Krishna says that udara sarva evente. Means all these four are fine for me, not a problem. But the jnani is knowledgeable person is exactly jnani tvatmaiva mimatam. Means according to me, jnani is the person who is very near and equal to the my highest self. Jnani becomes me. That's what he wants to say. Okay? And also he says that when these things happen, then the person becomes yuktatma. Okay? With that understanding, all these things require deep amount of faith, understanding and ability to expand the consciousness, which happens when we put aside our ego. With that understanding and taking a sankalpa to improve of the quality of our knees, we are going to come to physical practice. Adopt Namaskar Rudra, Omkar followed by Sahana Bhavatu. Inhale.
Express gratitude to Mother Earth, Almighty, your parents and Guru.
Slowly inhale and come up. Slowly release your hands. With few blinks, you may open your eyes. Suprabhatam. So let us begin today's session with Chair Surya Namaskar. We have been doing Chair Surya Namaskar for a long, long time. I am extremely sorry. I think now the quality. Now the quality will improve. Has it improved now? Suprabhatam. I think now it has improved because it was not connected. So let us begin. Is it better now, Godamani ji? Is it better? Yes. Okay. It happens. Suprabhatam. Now we are coming for to do Chair Surya Namaskar. Slight. Decrease the height so that you can see the knees. Okay. Now knees are seen in a better way. Okay. So adopt Namaskar Mudra. Omkar followed by Surya Mantra. Inhale. Patrena satyasya pihitam mukham tatvam pushanna pavrunu
सत्यधर्माय दृष्टये ॐ ह्रां मित्राय नमः एकम् स्लोली रिलीज योर सपोर्ट फ्रॉम द चेयर स्ट्रेट स्पाइन द्वे इनहेल टेक योर बोथ द हैंड्स अप एल्बोज स्ट्रेट बैक स्ट्रेट मसल्स आर कॉन्ट्रैक्टेड पैरास्पाइनल मसल्स एक्सहेल एल्बोज कीप स्ट्रेट स्प्रेड योर फिंगर्स कीप देम ओवर योर नीज फील योर नीज त्रिणी ओवर चत्वारी स्ट्रेटन योर राइट लेग दिस इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट नी पेन रिलेटेड एक्सरसाइज चत्वारी द लेग इज स्ट्रेटन एक्सहेल पंच इनहेल स्ट्रेटन द लेफ्ट लेग पुल योर टोज टुवर्ड्स यू दैट इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट एक्सहेल वी विल टॉक अबाउट ऑल दिस थिंग्स लेटर शट इनहेल लुक अप एक्सहेल बेंड फॉरवर्ड सप्त इनहेल एक्सहेल राइट हैंड अप एंड डाउन नव इनहेल लेफ्ट हैंड अप एंड देन डाउन नाउ इनहेल बेंड बैक अप कंप्लीटली एकादश एंड द्वादश नमस्कार मंत्र ओम ह्रीं रवये नमः एकम द्वे त्रीणि चत्वारि पंच षट् सप्त अष्ट नव दश एकादश द्वादश ओम ह्रूं सूर्याय नमः एकम द्वे त्रीणि चत्वारि पंच षट् सप्त अष्ट नव दश एकादश द्वादश ओम ह्रैं भानवे नमः एकम द्वे त्रीणि चत्वारि पंच षट् सप्त अष्ट नव दश एकादश द्वादश ओम ह्रौं खगाय नमः एकम द्वे त्रीणि चत्वारि पंच षट् सप्त अष्ट नव दश एकादश द्वादश ॐ रः पूष्णे नमः एकम् द्वे त्रीणि चत्वारि पञ्च षट् सप्त अष्ट नव दश एकादश द्वादश ॐ ह्रां हिरण्यगर्भाय नमः। ॐ ह्रीं मरीचये नमः। ॐ ह्रूं आदित्याय नमः। ॐ ह्रैं सवित्रे नमः। ॐ ह्रौं मार्गाय नमः। ॐ रः भास्कराय नमः। ॐ श्री सवित्रसूर्यनारायणाय नमः। रिलीज एंड रिलैक्स। ऑब्जर्व द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ सूर्य नमस्कार ऑन योर माइंड एंड बॉडी। यू कैन डू 12 ऑल्सो, बट एक्चुअली बिकॉज ऑफ लर्निंग सो मेनी दिव थिंग्स वी हैव केप्ट इट टू 6 एंड ऑन संडेज वी डू 12। ओके, ऑल्सो वी हैव टू एक्सप्रेस डीपेस्ट ग्रेटिट्यूड टू अल्टीमेट सोर्स ऑफ लाइफ एंड एनर्जी ऑन दिस प्लैनेट दैट इज सूर्य, सोलार एनर्जी दैट गेट्स ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड इन टू फूड थ्रू फोटोसिंथेसिस। Also, direct processes also happen through our skin, which is called as vitamin D formation, which by now, because of this corona pandemic, you would have come to know that it is of vital importance in development of immunity. That is one thing. Also, it is very important for our bone health. Many people who suffer from osteoporosis might be knowing that vitamin D supplement, calcium supplements have to be taken, correct? But naturally only vitamin D is formed, okay? So it is always better to have Surya Snana like we do Jala Snana, same way we can do Surya Snana also early in the morning with sunrise. If we wake up before sunrise, it is always good, because we will have finished our all daily routine activities and will be ready for auspicious things to happen. Actually, the rituals which have been developed in our culture are all associated with these kind of practices, where the background of all these things is health. Because if we are healthy, then only we can think of further development of knowledge, becoming Jnani, and then becoming Yuktatma. Okay, so with that understanding, we will understand further about our knees. Okay, now, knee, as you feel here, try to feel your knees. Okay, try to feel your knees. So what do you feel over here? There is a bone. Okay, this bone is called as tibia. Okay, on outer side, you will feel more of muscle. Okay, but still, just besides tibia on the outer side, there is a bone called as fibula, which does not take part in the formation of knee joint. So the tibia, it takes part in the formation of knee joint. You can feel a prominent thing here. Okay, this prominence which is down, it's nothing but tibia. Okay, and this line, whole line of bone, no, you will feel here, that is tibia. This bone is called as tibia. Okay, now if you feel, there is one triangular bone is there, that actually it's not exactly a bone, it's called sesamoid bone, it's called patella. And this patella, if you see, it moves a lot, and actually you can move it with your fingers if you try to. And it is attached with here. You feel here there are muscles, and if you contract these muscles and then feel, you will develop, you will feel those designs which Hanumanta, if you see Hanumanta's picture, Anjaneya picture, you will see nicely defined muscles over there. Okay, so these upper muscles of the thighs, they are very, very important in straightening of the knee. See, straightening of the knee. So this is very important. Why straightening of the knee? Because it provides great alignment. One. Second thing is, always a joint is moved around the joint. The movements which happen are happening because of the muscles. Always remember this, because this is the most important information and understanding which we should develop. Muscles, if they become weak, what will happen? Suppose I have to pack something, I have to keep something steady. How do I keep it? Do I keep it loose or do I pack it very tight? When we pack it tight, what is happening? It will not move and it will not get damaged. But if it is loose, then what may happen? The friction may happen between the packaging and the thing which we have put in the package. Correct? Agreed? Suppose if we have a box, this box is there. This box is there and this comb is there. Okay. So, what is happening? Sound is coming. But suppose this thing is packed nicely inside and it is closed properly as they do in Amazon. Okay. So they pack it and nothing will move as such. Okay. So what will happen? The movement, if the friction, if suppose there is something which is made up of glass, what will happen? It will break. Same way happens with the joint. Now what is going to happen if the muscles are not strong? If the muscles are not strong, the space between the two bones, this tibia and the bone which is there up, which is called as femur, there is a joint which is called as knee joint. And if these muscles are not strong, okay, the muscles around it are not strong, what is going to happen? There will be friction between the bones. And that friction, we always know, whenever friction happens, if you do friction between the two stones, what happens? The stones, if they are initially smooth, they will start frictioning and there will be scratches on that. Correct? Scratches. On the mobile also, we know, oh, scratches. Why? Because of friction. Because of two hard things coming in contact, because of friction, there will be scratches. To prevent that, there is something called as cartilage. But cartilage also, how long it will take care of this friction? Correct? That is why it is extremely important. It starts at the point of muscles. So muscles have to be strong. Now, how to keep the muscles strong? That is another question. Muscles, they take their, you know, understanding from your posture. Now, posture is extremely important. Is the posture of sitting in the chair good for the knees? No. Okay. So, sitting in the chair actually is not good for knees on long term. Not only the knees, but also our back and the neck region. Okay. So, this thing is extremely important, which we should understand. That is why this will form the basis of our practice. Okay. So, now come to standing position. So, always remember, muscles have to be strong. Muscles, all the muscles in the body have to be strong. How to make all the muscles in the body strong? Basic, most important practice, which we all are doing since last many days, Tadasana. Okay. So, I'll slightly raise it up. So, you know, that takes support from the wall to improve your alignment of the body. Okay. Legs are together, fingers are spread. Okay. Feet, you feel the distribution of weight. Okay. Now today we will slightly come away from the wall just to make you understand. Keep the feet together, toes are spread, and try to understand the distribution of weight. Okay. Slightly move your body forward, body, not the feet, and feel the pressure on the balls of your toes. Okay, and then slowly come back and try to feel the pressure on the heels, and with that try to bring the awareness up. What is happening here? What is happening in the thigh region, in the hip region? What is happening when you are doing this? Like swinging from front to back, front to back, and see which muscles are being used. Okay. Now, tilting. We know, no? Body roll in the car. Body roll in the car. Same way. See the body roll when you are tilting. What is happening when you are trying to transfer your weight to the left side of the leg and then right side? What's happening? See. Try to feel what muscles are coming into play. Now, if you get the idea of this, then you will try to distribute the weight evenly. And see, there is not a single point where you feel the burden of your body weight. Okay. Now, there comes the role of second thing, which is extremely important, which is obesity. What will happen? When the obesity is there, the center of gravity of the body will change. It will not pass through a straight line. And when it does not pass through a straight line, it is going to affect not only the knees, it is going to affect the lower back also. And all of us know that those who are obese will have invariably knee pain, invariably lower back pain. So it's all about architecture of the body. Okay, we all understand architecture of the buildings. We know what are the pillars and what is the construction and all these things, what is the design. So we have to respect, understand the design of our own body, and through that we have to improve our health. Okay, so now here we are going to practice Tadasana. Tadasana, one of the most important asanas, looks very easy, but with regular practice you will see drastic changes in your posture, in your knee pain, joint pain, back pain, neck pain, anything. And overall your confidence also is going to improve. Okay, so Tadasana, legs together, tighten your calf muscles, tighten your knees, tighten your thighs, tighten your hips, exhale and suck your abdomen in. Inhale and expand your chest. Hands by the side of the body, looking forward, gentle smile on your face. So this is Tadasana. Okay, so this, like, full body is tight. Okay, if you come and like feel my body, these muscles are tight. These muscles are tight. This muscle is slightly tight, but not completely, because it helps in breathing. Okay, and at the same time, if you hold paraspinal muscles, they are also tight. So one straight line which goes like this behind is completely, you know, under tension. Okay, and hands also. So this becomes Tadasana. Now in Tadasana, if we want to improve the knees, okay, so you loosen your thighs and then tighten, loosen, tighten, loosen, tighten, loosen, tighten. So this is also possible. Okay, and we had done on that day the march past practice like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, which is of extreme importance, because it will help the muscles to move, at the same time develop strength as well. Okay, initially you may not be able to do, slowly slowly you have to improve. Now if you are not able to do that, then complete Tadasana stretch, full body stretch, interlock your fingers, touch your thumbs against each other, inhale, exhale. There are people who are not able to do this also because of many reasons to start with. Their shoulders are fixed, their shoulders are rigid, their elbows are rigid, their knees are also stiff. Okay, so improve with practice, improve, and do only up to your comfort level. Inhale, exhale. And try to take cognizance of your knee joint. Okay, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Two more rounds. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Synchronization with breathing is extremely important. Release and relax. Now we are going to sit. See, if you can't sit, I will have to show on the chair. If you can sit, it is the best thing which you can do. Try to sit on the floor and try to improve. Okay. Today I will show on the chair simple things which can be done. Okay. As we have already seen, straightening of the legs. Okay. Straightening of the legs, which is you just keep and straighten, tighten your muscles, feel your muscles here. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. After some time only you will start feeling stiffness over here. So when you start feeling tight, you should massage your thighs. Self massage is also okay. Then calf muscles, you should massage the calf muscles as well, which will release the tension from the joint. Okay, you can just massage around the knees as well. Now this kneecap movement also can be done, which should be done in straight leg position, in a relaxed position, which you can do in sitting position. Okay, now slight amount of practice, like folding like this, and see what happens. Okay, one knee above the other knee, one knee above the other knee. Now this is not only about the knee, it is also about the hip also. If you see, what's happening is hip is internally rotating. Okay, hip is internally rotating, which is also important. If you fold, there will be some external rotation of the hip and there will be some changes in the thigh as well. Okay, so these are the practices which can be done very gently. Okay, I am doing slightly fast to cover the things, but you can do it slowly with inhalation and exhalation orientation. Okay, inhale and then exhale, inhale, exhale. Okay, now you can fold your knee and keep it like this. That is also possible. With this, what you can try to do is hold your toes and then slowly try to straighten. Okay, initially it may not happen, but slowly with practice it will start happening. Inhale, exhale, inhale. Okay, so start doing that. You will come to know that it will not only help you to improve your knees, it will also help you to improve your shoulders, improve your spine, all these things. Once again, we'll practice. You can hold the ankle also. Inhale, exhale, straight knee. Okay. Inhale, exhale. Now hold the ankle. Inhale, exhale. See, initially it may not happen, okay? It may not happen completely, but it should happen and you should feel the stretch in this region, okay? Now, one more important practice is squatting. Initially, you may not be able to sit on the floor. So, can you just avoid squatting? No. What you should do is, you should start squatting or doing squatting and Tadasana from Uttanasana. Uttanasana pose from the chair. Okay. So, adopt Namaskara Mudra or you can adopt Kshepana Mudra, which is index finger straight and other fingers are interlocked. Left thumb is on the right thumb. And then inhale and rise up. Inhale first and then rise up with exhalation. Now, here what is important is not standing up. What is important is activating the thigh muscles, hip muscles, all these things. Okay, so I will show you from the side view. It's not just standing up, it is far beyond that. Okay, so when you are sitting, inhale, exhale. Now what has happened is, if you observe, I have tightened my hips, I have tightened my thighs. Okay, so this is extremely important for not only knees but also hips, also for the lower back. Okay, inhale, go back, exhale. See the difference? There is a slight difference of 10 degrees or maybe lesser even, but that is the difference which will make your knees stronger, make your knees more flexible, and make your knees healthy. Okay, so this is the half squat. Okay, partial uttanasana. And if you want to do utkatasana, which is chair pose, so chair pose is not only sitting in the chair, it is about having the shape like a chair. So what you can do is and hold. So here, even if you know that there is a chair beneath, so whenever you feel too much tensed, you will come down easily. Okay, so like this you can do. Inhale, hold, normal breathing, exhale, release and relax. The same thing can be practiced against the wall, which I feel is more dynamic and helps to balance the spine better. At the same time, provides nice practice to the knees as well. Legs apart, away from the wall by almost 1 to 1.5 feet. Okay, you can keep your hands down also and go down like this and come up. When you come up, exhale and squeeze your thighs. Okay, I'm going to slightly remove this mat because it's causing some instability. Okay, so you see here, you can keep your hands up also. I feel hands up is a better position because it helps the shoulders also. Inhale, see, I'm going down, my spine is in complete contact with the wall. Exhale. So when you are exhaling, don't jerk, allow these muscles to work. Squeeze the hips, squeeze the thighs, so your body will get lifted up. Okay, once again, let us do that. Inhale, utkatasana, exhale. Now there are some practices which can be intensified by keeping the legs together. So utkatasana with legs together. Inhale, you will come to know what happens. Exhale, when you practice, you will come to know. Inhale, exhale. Now going the full round, those who improve and those who start developing more and more flexibility, or those who are youngsters, because many youngsters are also there, for them going completely down is going to benefit them. Okay, so what we are going to do is, inhale, completely down you can go. Okay, completely down. Here the knees become very, very flexible. Complete movement is there that will help to improve the anatomy of the joint also. Okay, now exhale. How to exhale? So you can do this Kshepana Mudra and then inhale, exhale like a rocket. Inhale, exhale. Always remember to keep your spine straight. Inhale, Exhale. Okay, so this is the practice for knees in standing position. If we want to improve in the sitting position, then never move your mat with your legs, okay? Mat is the place where we do meditation. It has to be respected, and accordingly, we have to behave with the mat, okay? Now, take the support of the wall. We are in Dandasana. Dandasana itself gives a lot of relief to the knees, okay? But it depends upon how much we take the benefit from Dandasana. Pull your toes, so automatically the thighs will tighten, okay? So this is the loose, tight, loose, tight, tight, tight. So here you will see the movement of the kneecap, that is called as patella. So I'm moving my kneecap, okay? You can move side by side, you can move up and down, you can try to circulate it, reverse. So all these things are possible. What I feel is you should massage your muscles also, so that they get stimulated and they are used. Now I think somebody had shared, no? I think Shivashankarji had shared that strength of our muscles, yes, it is associated with longevity. It is associated with health of our joints, okay? So that is why regular practice is of paramount importance, okay? Now, we can do Janu Shirsasana if possible. It's not necessary to practice everything. It is up to our comfort level we should practice. Na hathat, na balat. Okay, so we can practice before that. We can practice Baddha Konasana, Titliasana and all these things which are very good for hips, knees, ankles, spine, everything, lower abdominal organs. So there are no specific practices as such for anything. Every practice will have overlapping benefits. Okay, so this is Titliasana. Daily try to do this, daily. It has extreme benefits, okay? If you can do this, then slowly try to bend forward and try to go into Baddha Konasana, okay? If you try to touch your, if you are able to touch your forehead, then try to touch your chin, okay? Inhale and come back. Now keep the left leg over there only and release the right leg. Okay, there are some practices which people tell that keep the ankle between the, like you keep it in contact with the pelvic floor, the pelvic muscles. This is the pelvic region. So there are floor of the pelvis, you keep the muscle, you keep the ankle touching the muscles. Okay, between, for males, between the root of the penis and the anus region, and for females at the vaginal door, okay, which helps to improve circulation over there and activate the Mooladhara chakra, okay. So now this is called as Janu Shirsasana. Janu means knee joint. Janu means knee joint, okay, and Shirsha means head. So what is going to happen? The head is going to touch the knee. But means it should not be touched like this. It should be touched with the knee straight. Okay. So Janu Shirsasana is not your comfort, but initially, even if it is partial, that is fine. Slowly, slowly it will come. Okay. So if you want to practice very gently, try to, it's not about touching the forehead to the knee. It is always about touching the abdomen to the thigh. Because if you are able to successfully touch the abdomen to the thigh, automatically your body is completely parallel to the thighs and it will, the head will touch the knee also. Okay, so let us practice that. Try to touch abdomen to the thigh. Exhale. So your focus should be on touching the abdomen to the thigh.
And then automatically we are able to touch head to the knee.
Janu Shirasana. Inhale and come back. Always crunch the right side of the abdomen first. We have discussed this. The fecal matter flows from right to left and then passes down. Okay. So let us do it on the left side crunching. Okay. Inhale. Look up. Exhale. Crunch your abdomen on the left side. I am not hurrying to touch my forehead to the knee. I am enjoying the touching of the abdomen to the thigh and keeping my knee straight. Okay. Inhale. Come up. Exhale. So this is Janu Shirsasana. Okay. Like this, there are many different kinds of practices. Inhale and exhale, release. Now there is something called as Ardha Padmasana, Ardha Padma Paschimottanasana we can do, which is folding the left leg, keeping the ankle close to the umbilicus and putting it on the right thigh. Okay. So this is Ardha Padma. Now leg is straight, so we can do Paschimottanasana. Paschimottanasana means the back of the body is going to become up and straight. Okay. Up means facing towards the sky. So that can be done. This is for advanced practitioners. Even if you want to try, you can try, but try gently up to your comfort level. Okay. So let us practice. Inhale, exhale. Now you will be seeing how ankle is putting the pressure on the right side. I have seen many people, when I make them do this practice, they will ask to pass the gas and they will be ready to pass the stools also. Chronic constipation, amazing results with this. Okay.
Inhale.
I think I have shown this on chair also, that you can practice the same thing on chair also if possible. Okay. And I exhale, release. Now right side is crunched, left side will crunch. Always remember, right first followed by left in crunching of the abdomen. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, release and relax. So obviously Padmasana is also going to be one of the asana for knee pain, but you will tell, I have knee pain, how I will do it? Don't do it. See, to begin with, don't do it. Do these practices which have been shown initially, and then slowly, and it's for youngsters, those who are young, and even your children who are young, please make them learn Padmasana. It's not just one fancy asana for the Instagram. It is the asana for your future. It is the asana for improving the health of the knees. So those who are elderly, they should emphasize the importance of yoga asana, yoga practice. Okay, I remember once again, Sridevi Patil, her photos we have shared on WhatsApp group. She, her daughter only had shared, and she had told, she has never met me, it's only through YouTube. And she practiced, and now she has been practicing for a long time, but she was not able to do since last few years. And her knees had become stiff, her body had become stiff. Now once again she is able to do Padmasana at 70 years of age, 70. Padmasana she is able to do. I always, when after they shared, no, I always remember whenever I do Padmasana, it becomes like, oh, the face of Sridevi Patil comes to my mind. Why? Because at 70 years of age, she has developed that courage and she has improved, not only in that manner, that physical practice, her sugars have normalized. Before fasting and after, before eating food and after eating food, both are normal now. That is the power of yogic practice at 70 years of age. These examples have to be taken into mind, and not like we should start fighting with our body, we should start overdoing the things. Ati sarvatra varjayet. Ati sarvatra varjayet. Do not do excessive practice, because already if you are old, your body is weak. So develop the strength step by step, slowly. Do not try to overdo the things. Okay? With that, there are many further practices in knee. Okay? So we will continue this knee practice for another 2-3-4 days, and we will enjoy different kinds of asanas and all. Okay? If you have any difficulty, any questions, you can ask later on also in the comment section, you can ask in the group also. But we are planning to conduct this knee related practices for next at least 3-4 days. Okay? But the languages will change. Tomorrow it will be in Hindi. Day after tomorrow it will be in Marathi. Then Kannada. Then Gujarati. Okay? So, be ready for that. Now, we are going to perform yogic breathing. Yogic breathing we are going to do together today. Just for an orientation. First fill your stomach, then fill your chest, and then finally lift your shoulders. Okay, for that the mudra is Brahma mudra. So thumb is inside, wrapped by four fingers, and then keep them around your umbilicus. Yogic breathing directly. Okay, inhale, bulge your abdomen, chest, and lift your shoulders. Exhale, shoulders down, empty the chest and empty the abdomen. Inhale, exhale. Exhale. Release and relax. Now, asana practice for knee pain. Over pranayam, simple breathing we have done, yogic breathing. This you can increase the number of repetitions later on. Now we are going towards mudra. Mudra is Vayu mudra. For any joint related problem, any nerve related problem, we have to practice Vayu mudra. So take your index finger, keep it pressed by the thumb. Observe the joint position. Okay, observe the joint position and observe the thumb position. That is why I am marking it. And then it is beyond the second joint. Okay, and then see here. This is Vayu mudra. This is how Vayu mudra looks. Okay? Here you have to feel the pulse. The point at which the index finger is pressing on the thenar eminence, we call it as the bulging at the base of the thumb. Okay? There you have to feel the pulse. Keep the back erect, neck erect. Close your eyes and try to observe the pulse at the contact points. Vayu mudra. slowly. Another thing which is happening with knee pain and all these things is that calcium deficiency is there, vitamin D deficiency is there. For that, we perform Shankha Mudra. All of us know how to perform Shankha Mudra. Okay, the thumb will go into the center of the palm, wrapped by the fingers, and an index finger will be touching. The right hand index finger will be touching the left thumb, and vice versa. So it will look like this. It will look something like this. Okay, I hope you are able to see it. Okay, and this you can keep in a relaxed manner in your lap. You can keep at the chest level also. You can keep at the level of your eyebrows also. Okay, depends upon where you find the energy moving. Okay, so this is Shankha Mudra. Keep your eyes closed for a while. Try to observe the pulse and the tip of index finger and the thumb. And the thumb with this, which is wrapped by four fingers. Try to enjoy the Shankha Mudra. It's not only this, or not only about calcium, vitamin D. It's also about the thyroid function. It is also about the voice which is generated in our throat. It's also about the neck region, okay, the Shankha Mudra. And it is extremely auspicious mudra. It overall improves the immunity of the body. Vayu Mudra followed by Shankha Mudra. There are many more mudras also to improve our overall joint health. However, because we have finished 1 hour, we can finish it with Prana Mudra, that is third and the fourth finger tips touching the tip of the thumb, trying to feel the pulse. Extremely important to feel the pulse. Okay, and then about you can increase the duration with regular practice, that mudra practice. And there are many other mudras which we'll discuss over a period of time in next 2-3 days. Okay, so every day practice will not be same. And this whole session is about improving your awareness towards all these things. It's not some kind of protocol. There is no protocol in yoga. Every person is different. Every person's prakriti is different. Okay, so according to your prakriti, you should be able to practice. And how to enjoy and understand your prakriti is to allow yourself through the experience. When you feel good with your practice, it means that it is going to benefit you. If you are not feeling good, even after the practice, you feel that no, today my energy levels have gone down. So it means that there is something wrong with your practice. You can contact me also. You can contact your yoga guru also, who is there nearby your place, and you can try to correct your practices also. Okay, you can ask questions also, we can discuss and we can try to improve the experience in yoga. Okay, with that understanding, slowly adopt Namaskara Mudra. Omkar followed by Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha. Keeping in the mind the benefits which we have reaped in today's practice, trying to expand our consciousness. Inhale. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha. Sarve Santu Niramaya. Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu. Ma kaschid dukha bhag bhavet. Om Shantihi, Shantihi, Shantihi. With your eyes closed, slowly take your hands back. Hold your right wrist with the left palm. Inhale, arch your back. Exhale, bend from the root of the back, touch your forehead to the ground. Express gratitude to Mother Earth, Almighty, your parents and Guru. Slowly inhale and come up. Slowly release your hands with few blinks. Before that, you rub your eyes, rub your hands, and keep the warm hands on your eyes, head, neck, shoulder, arms, forearms, chest, abdomen, thighs, and the legs. Specifically on your knees, you try to massage your knees for a while. Give the relief to the knees, clockwise, anti-clockwise, and rotate. And slowly open your eyes with few blinks. Dhanyavada. Try to practice, try to chant mantra together. It is good that we all, you know, chant together and develop that sense of improving the collective consciousness. Live chat. Extremely good session. Thanks. Thank you, sir. Thank you, doctor, for the good session. I will make regular practice for my children who always say their knee pains. Children are saying knee pain. Abba, abba. Yeah, that is true, because I met a 15-year-old boy. He was not even able to do simplest of the things. 15-year-old boy, if I want to say, his body was like 60-year-old person. Okay, so difficult. Suprabhatam, everybody. Dhanyavadam. Okay, so always remember, all of us have to be healthy, happy, and prosperous together. None of us should suffer. All of us have to live in harmony and peace along with all other plants and animals also. Smiling knee, happy knees. Very good. Okay. So have a nice day. Oh, one second. Before going, I will just show you. There are many new people, no, over here. There are many new people. For these new people, this you start taking. This is called as the powder made up from jeera. Okay. This is made up of jeera, which is 50 grams. And yellu, white yellu, it is called as in Kannada, sesam seeds, white sesam seeds. And jaggery, if you can see jaggery piece here. Do not try to mix it in the mixture grinder. You mix it with stone. The stone thing will be there, no? Stone crusher. Through that, you do that and make this kind of a powder, coarse powder, and take 1 teaspoon daily. This will help your joints to become healthy, one. Second thing is, it's going to improve the flexibility of your muscles as well. So I recommend all of you to take this. Either you take it in the night or you take it in the morning, early morning, before starting the session. There is no hard and fast rule for this. It's a very simple procedure. It's a very simple preparation. It's going to help to improve the health of the joints, muscles, improve the flexibility. So through that, you will see drastic changes. Many of our practitioners who are with us since last 6.5 months, they all have benefited a lot through this preparation. So I just wanted to share with all of you. There are many new people. So I thought I will just repeat the same. Okay. Have a nice day. Dhanyavad. Thank you, Godamani ji. Namaste. Namaste. Jai Lakshmi.